Peace in the Lord, beloved brothers and sisters. Peace, mercy, grace from God the Father of all creation, and our great Lord, the rock that we are hewn from. Amen. To God bless us with another and promised Sabbath day to rejoice and be glad in Him, to give Him glory and honor Him for who He is and what He's doing for us in our lives. Amen. Praise God. And as we're releasing holy angels from the kingdom of heaven to sit here and be with us in each and every day that we are, wherever we are going, beloved brothers and sisters, and all of you saints that have an ear to hear. Amen. Praise God. I've been going through these times, beloved brothers and sisters, and, you know, use this advice for more than just sitting in around in a bump on a log and doing things. Get out there and do what God has called us and created us to do, especially in these end times, you children of light, you light workers, amen, you door, you keepers of the covenant. That we claim our covenant-keeping God is with us always, and He is there. He is there to lead us, to guide us, to protect us, to provide for us in all our needs. And we being knitted together and woven together from every nation, every tribe, and every tongue. Amen. Praise God. Frustrating the devices of the enemy, as the Lord tells us. And we're going to read some of that in this book of Job. Amen. Praise God. That He frustrates the devices of the enemy. And we don't want to be found to be that the Lord of hosts is sitting here and frustrating us in our ways. Amen. Praise God for being disobedient, rebellious, or selective in how we choose to sit here and remain faithful to our covenant-keeping God. Amen. Praise God in this day and age. And that's why many people in this day and age, saints, many spirits are not finding, they claim it. Amen. They profess it out their clay lips that we stand on firm foundation. Our faith is built on the rock, but they're stumbling and their house is being blown down. Amen. Praise God. And they're not understanding that. But maybe we need to evaluate ourselves each and every day, beloved brothers and sisters, as we go through these times, evaluating our lives, combing through it with the Holy Spirit that is within us, so that way that we can be found where the Lord needs us to be. Amen. Nothing that we can do, but God that does everything for us through Christ, through us. Amen. Praise God. We're going to sit here and pray. We're going to praise. We're going to worship the living God. And on His holy sanctified Sabbath day, you know, the Lord of hosts, as we are drawing close to knowing the truth of the word, you know, not contending with the word of God was not created for you spirits to sit here and contend with, but to obey and instruct and be able to allow ourselves to be led in truth, amen, not in defeat, so we can be standing in victory. Amen. Praise God. There's victory for you if you want it, but there is a price that you have to pay for that victory, and that is to lose your life, to find it in Christ, and not just what's convenient to you spirits, but everything that is written for us too. Amen. So as we're going through this time, we're going to pray, we're going to praise, we're going to worship the living God, and sing a praise and worship song too. I'm not going to be here on here very much because I don't know how much time that my tablet has on it, because we've had a God bless this servant with a fun fellowship with a brother from the UK and another brother from India and another brother from Puerto Rico. We all sat on this device from different countries and different time zones and fellowshipped about the goodness and the mercy and the grace and the truth to encourage, to uplift, to edify, and to do whatever the Holy Spirit needed to be revealed unto each and every one of us. Amen. That's how the Holy Spirit works, to help us grow in the knowledge of the truth with the wisdom and understanding that only comes from the heavens, that is not given to everybody, beloved brothers and sisters, but those that are called, chosen, the elect. Because the other ones, God knows what spirits are going to be rebellious and want to be selective and want to be, we're here to sit here and follow all the truth, the way, and the life to eternal life. Amen. Praise God. So let us pray. We are going to pray. Amen. And then we're going to praise a song or two, and then get to reading some word. Amen. And talk about and bless God on His holy sanctified Sabbath day each day. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this opportunity that you've given us to grow stronger. You blessed our day each day, Father God, when your mercy is upon our life. We know, Lord of hosts, God of all creation, that your grace is with us. But your mercy, Lord, if there was no mercy, there wouldn't be no grace, Lord, for us that are truthfully knowing you, Lord, and seeking you, and to know and grow closer and to know our Father's heart. We love you more than life itself, Father God, and we bless you on this sanctified Sabbath day. And on our knees, Father God, we enter your courts with a heart full of thanksgiving and praise. For you are our praise, Lord. You are the only thing that's worthy to be speaking of, because we're found in you, Father God. And for you to have blessed those that are out here, giving us all an opportunity to sit here and come to you, Father God, in faith and truth and full assurance of knowing that you are there with us and for us and guiding us and leading us into all things, Lord. There's nothing impossible for you are the God of the impossible. So when anybody is struggling, Father God, out there, being able to feel and know that you are doing things, Father God, they need to remind them, Lord, remind them, Holy Father, that you're the God of the impossible. There's no impossibilities with you, Father God. It's not good for us. That's the only reason that you let it come to us, Father God, or come to pass for us. For only you know why. We love you more than life itself, Father God. We bless your holy name on this sanctified Sabbath day of you, Father God. As obedient servants, as obedient called, as obedient chosen people to keep your commandments, for the covenant-keeping God to keep the covenant with us for the thousand generations. Many people like to lean on that, Father God, but there is rules, there's guidelines, there's precepts, there's judgments. There are ordinances that we have to keep that covenant fully with you, Father God, that many people are unaware. I'm asking that your mercy be upon their lives and that your Spirit, Holy Spirit, that you touch them to consider. To consider, Holy Father, the things that will be spoken to them. Fill them with knowledge and wisdom. Enlighten them with the Holy Spirit, Father God, that you give unto those that obey you, Father God, as you tell us in your book. Your whole word. I love you, Father God. Move the mountains that we need to continue moving. Make our path straight, Father God, and start binding the work of the enemy that's around us and start setting captives free, Holy Father. Unloosen the bondages, the shackles, and the chains for many people that are in this place, Father God, bound by the flesh, Lord. And as we sit here and we go with you, thinking that they are walking freedom and walking obediently to you, Father God, by serving the flesh. And that devil, that deception that many people are living and abiding in instead of in you. Forgive us, Father, for if we have sinned against you, wash us, cleanse our garments, cleanse our hearts, cleanse our souls, cleanse our spirits, cleanse our minds, cleanse our hearts, Father God, for we need you. We're nothing without you. By faith and believing you, great I am, our Elohim, Lord, I love you so much. Abba, Father, Jehovah, Yeshua, great I am, Master Christ, Yeshua, HaMashiach, Jesus, Jesus, in your name that all things are done in, Father God, we lift our hands, our petitions, our causes, our issues, our cares, and our concerns, for I know that you are working all things out for those that truly follow you and love you, Father God. We're here as living witness, we're lights in the darkness, Father God, help us, lead us, guide us, purge us, perfect us and put us in that fire, Father God, until you make us those instruments worthy of you and for you. In Christ Yeshua, Messiah, Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord, beloved brothers and sisters. Amen. My brother gave me some tassels. I got blessed yesterday because I've been, you know, as we're getting close to knowing the word of truth, all of you spirits that have an ear to hear, to say your followers away, you know, God, it's been in my heart to learn the ways of his people, as the word of truth tells us, learn the ways of my people, as you guys have been taught much about the ways of Baal. Amen. Praise God. And God commanded us to sit here and have tassels. embroidered on the quarter, on the hem of our clothing, and his brother blessed me with some. Amen. And to have fringes along the side of our garment, and this brother, bless his heart, blessed me with some. Amen. To be able to wear for us that are God's people. Amen. He gave us a way to be able to dress in royalty. Amen. So he blessed me with this the other day, and yesterday, as a matter of fact, when all kinds of things were happening around me, God was still working things out, keeping me in perfect peace and sending me gifts. Amen. The Lord was sending me gifts through my brothers so that way we could sit here and be dressed the way he wants, needs us to be. And it's awesome. It's awesome. It's awesome. And I will be wearing this. I'm going to go buy me some more of this today to be able to make this. And of course, it was embroidered with the name of our Messiah. Amen. Yahweh, great I am. The I am that I am. For us that are called by his name. But that's love. So we're going to be reading some Job today. But let us praise a song or two, okay? And I love to praise. I love to sing. But there's a lot of people that are being misled, beloved brothers and sisters. And it's time for you people of God to sit here and know that the Father is there. Abba Hushiawa. Praise you. Into your hands I commit again, with all I am, for you, Lord, you hold our hand in the palm of your hand, and I am yours forever. Jesus, I believe in you. Yeshua, we belong to you. You're the reason that I sing, the reason that I sing with all I am. I walk with you wherever you go, through tears and I'll trust you, Lord. I love you, Father, and I will live, Lord, in all of your ways, Holy Father God, your promises forever. Jesus, I believe in you. Yeshua, we belong to you. You're the reason that we live, the reason that we sing, Father God. Jesus, Jesus, Yeshua, we love you, Father God. Jesus, I belong to you. You're the reason that we live, the reason that we see, with all we are. Abba Kushawa. We praise you, Father God. We bless your holy name on this sanctified Sabbath day, Lord. We're asking you to lead us and to guide us, Father God. Let it be in your will that all things are done, Father God. For we trust and we have faith in you, Holy Father God of all creation. You are the I Am. You are the Creator. You are the Lord of our lives. You are the King of nations, Father God. We will worship you. I will worship you. I will worship you. I will worship you. Yeshua, I believe in you, Holy Father God. I know that you're there, that you're leading us by still waters, Father God. In by pastures of green grass, Father God, we can lay still knowing that you are working all things out, that you are sitting here contending for us, Father God, that you are leading us and that you are guiding us, Father God, and that you're leading us and you're giving us and blessing us with your blessed, precious Holy Spirit, Father God, and filling us with your light, with your truth, with your knowledge, with your wisdom, Father God, is above and better than anything in this world. We're asking you to search our hearts, Father God, to search our minds, and to sit here and lead us, Lord. I will worship you. I will worship you. Father God, we worship you. With all our being, with all our hearts, Father God, we open our hearts to you and ask your Holy Spirit to come in. And we ask you, Father God, to always lead us and guide us and to forgive us when we do sit here in error in our ways, Lord, for falling weak to the flesh. Strengthen us in your spirit, Father God. Strengthen us in your word. Quicken us, Holy Spirit, as we sit here and bless this new day that you have made. Believe. We believe in you, Lord. Yeshua, and we trust and we belong to you, Lord. Above you, Holy Father, there is no one. Beneath you, there is no one, Lord. We love you. Jesus, I believe in you. Yeshua, we belong to you, Holy Father, in all things, Lord. Not just what's convenient for us, Father God, for you are the great I Am. We're asking you to see here, Lord, and always bless this land, this reservation, and these lost souls, and these spirits that are sitting here walking. In the way that is not of you. The reason that we live with Lord. Bless your holy name, Father God. We love you more than life itself. Show us, lead us, and guide us. We need you, Father God. Let your Holy Spirit come down, Father. Teach us to know what it is to carry our cross. Teach us to know how to forsake our way. We need you, Lord. We worship you. I will worship you, Father God. Always knowing that you already worked all things out, Lord. For the good or for the evil. We will worship you. Bless your holy name on this sanctified Sabbath day, Father God. Open up the windows of heaven, Holy Father God, and let your Holy Spirit sit here and fall on us. Amen. So as we sit here going through this time, beloved brothers and sisters, we're going to have a few minutes to sit here and read the book of Job. Amen. The book of Job tells us in 16 Actually, in 17, can a mortal be more righteous than God? Can a man be more pure than his maker? If he puts no trust in his servants, if he charges his angels with error, how much more those who dwell in the houses of clay? Amen, all of you spirits that have an ear to hear. How much more, just in that scripture alone, spirits, tells us that we can't be more righteous than God, but we are just in the righteousness of Christ for God. Amen, praise God. And we cannot be more pure than our Maker, but we can be made pure through the Christ, that strength to washes away our sins, washes and makes us clean when we get baptized in the name of Christ Jesus, and be filled with the Spirit of the living God, the whole precious Holy Spirit. And he tells us, if he can put no trust in his servants, if he charges his angels with error, how much more those who dwell in the houses of clay, whose foundation is in that dust, who are crusted before a moth, they are broken in pieces from morning till evening. They perish forever with no one regarding. Does not their own excellence go away? They die without wisdom. Amen. And that's a lot of people. And you spirits that are receiving that, that are believed to the Almighty, the Messiah, please hear me. Amen. For many people are very selective in how you want to read your Bible. But right there, he tells them, if he charges his angels with error, how much more us that dwell in houses of clay, being spirits. Amen. Call out now. Is there anyone who can answer you? And to which of the holy ones will you turn? For wrath kills a foolish man, and envy slays a simple one. I have seen the folly taking root, but suddenly I cursed his dwelling place. His sons are far from safety. They are crushed in the gate, and there's no deliverer, because the hungry eat up his harvest. Take it even from the thorns, and the snare snatches their sustenance. For affliction does not come from the dust, nor does trouble spring from the ground. Yet man is born to trouble as the sparks fly upward. But as for me, I would seek God, and to God I would commit my cause. Amen. To God you can commit your cause. Who does great things and unsearchable. We like to hear that, right? But remember, if he charges his angels with that, how much more us that dwell in the house of clay spirits. Amen. Who does great things and unsearchable, marvelous things without number. He gives rain on the earth and sends water on the fields. He sets on high those who are lowly, and those who mourn are lifted up to safety. He frustrates the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot carry out their plans. He catches the wise in their own craftiness, and the counsel of the cunning comes quickly upon them. They meet with darkness in the daytime, and grope at noontime as in the night. But he saves the needy from the sword, from the mouth of the mighty, and from their hand. So the poor have hope, and injustice shuts her mouth. And I'm going to give you a little testimony in just a minute of how this scripture will come to life for you if you obey all of what the Almighty has written for us, repent our hearts, and make an honest vow to the Lord that you're going to keep his way, his judgment, his precepts, amen, his peace. And we're all going to learn together, beloved brothers and sisters. I'm not greater than anybody else. It's just, I know. Amen. Because he gives us wisdom. He gives us understanding. He gives us knowledge. When we don't want to buck. When we don't want to cast the words that could save your soul and your life spirits behind you. Because you let the flesh and all that perversity and crookedness and everything that you have been instilled in your mind to not obey, that leads your flesh to cause an error. Behold, happy is the man who God corrects. Therefore, do not despise the chastening of the Almighty, for he bruises, but he'll bind up, but he binds up. He wounds, but his hands make whole. He shall deliver you in 6 troubles. Yes, in 7, no evil shall touch you. In famine, he shall redeem you from death, and in war from the power of the sword. You shall be hidden from the scourges of the tongue, and you shall not be afraid of destruction when it comes. You shall laugh at destruction and famine. And you shall not be afraid of the beasts of the earth, for you shall have a covenant with the stones of the field. And the beasts of the field shall be at peace with you. You shall know that your tent, you shall know that your tent, this tunic of skin, is in peace. You shall visit your dwelling and find nothing amiss. You shall also know that your descendants shall be many, and your offspring like the grass of the earth. You shall come to the grave at a full age, as a sheaf of grain ripens in its season. Behold, this we have searched out as is true. Hear it and know it for yourself. Amen. God doesn't tell us to know it for somebody else. God says to know it for yourself. And the only way that we can know it for ourselves, spirits, is if when we are walking with God obediently to all that he has said, because he himself will sit here and teach you all things. Amen. Praise God. And he will instill them in your heart, so that way when you are truly in the spirit of the living God, beloved brothers and sisters, that guess what? He'll convict you when we're doing things that are not written for us to do, and obeying still the flesh and doctrines of man, as many people. We still want to be, we want to be right over here, but we're leaving this undone. And I spoke of that the other day. You know, as the Lord commanded me, we can't do the love without the correction and the laws. Amen. Don't just sit here and be in that. You can fall for that okey-doke if you want to, spirits, but you can't do one and leave the other one undone. Just as my master Christ sat here and told the Pharisees and Sadducees, you look to the law, but you let the love undone. Well, a lot of y'all are now twisted the other way. Y'all want to sit here and look at the love, but y'all don't want to obey the law. So you're leaving one undone without the other, and many people are walking unstable and unwhole. Amen. Though we profess it on our clay lips, are you truly doing that? Are you standing in the strength? Are you standing in the full assurance of your faith? Because if you are that, and you're professing that, spirits, well, guess what? There shall be no weakness in you. There shall be no excuses coming out of your lips. Amen. Praise God. Nothing but solid, yet your yes be no, and your no be no. That's not for us to sit here and do, and I'm not going to do it. Amen. Praise God. And sometime, and that's why God is speaking from every family, one, from every city, from every, he tells us this. Amen. He frustrates the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot carry out. But we, many people, being a stubborn, rebellious people, well, we're going to scheme over here, but God's going to catch you too, saints, and all of you spirits that have near to here. Just because you get away from it here, doesn't mean that you're going to get away with it on judgment day when the books are open before you there. Because all of it is written for each and every one of us. Everything that we have done. Behold, and he tells us, happy is the man that the Lord corrects. Amen? If we allow God to sit here and work with you, spirits, I'm telling you, I'm here as a living testimony. And I can't do nothing but come and show you, spirits. Amen. I'm somebody that has been obedient, a ratchet wretch, the filth of this earth, the scum of the earth, that the Father blessed. He blessed me with his spirit. As he blessing everybody with an opportunity. Amen. He's blessing you with an opportunity to sit here and be right with him and be filled with him and be filled with the spirit and to sit here and appreciate what Christ has did, what he did for you, what the Almighty Sovereign God has done for us. Amen. Already, not what he's going to do for you, but what he's already done for you. Amen. Praise God. Everything else is a blessing. And what's even greater is the mercy to know that you've been forgiven and to know that you could be made new and made whole, as the word of truth tells us. Amen. For we cannot be more righteous than God. And it don't matter how many people choose to sit here and look into that, it's how God, how it's written, that's going to matter. Amen. I'm not going to be on here too long, but just to give you a little testimony. You know, I gave my life to, well, God chooses us. Nothing that we can give God. He's got to choose us. It don't matter how long you sit in that church building, spirits. If God has not ordained that for you. And this is what people don't understand. We are a chosen people. We are a chosen person. We got a purpose. And it's not only in this darkness to be made lights of the world, in the darkness to bring truth. Amen. But we are ordained for the purpose of receiving eternal salvation in heaven. And that's not everybody from every nation, every tribe, and every tongue, spirits. Amen. It's only those that God has called all nations to repentance, so that way you might be able to be counted worthy. The Bible does tell you that. Because everything that we have done will be there. And when God is trying to catch you at your craftiness, spirits, if the Almighty Sovereign God is there trying to seek you and direct you in a way, he's showing you, hey, I'm watching what you're doing. And I'm going to sit here and try to keep you from committing that error. But many people in this day and age, God got so conniving and scheming that you'll go around this way. Okay, but if that door didn't open, I'm going to go over here and try and lie and cheat and scheme or steal, rob, commit iniquity and error just to please the flesh or people instead of God. Amen. Praise God. And that's all of you spirits that have an ear to hear. And if that is you this day, we read it. God catches you. He's catching you, and it's going to be there. So it's better for us to repent our way. For the word of truth tells us that we have a God that shows partiality to no man, nobody, not even from that person that's supposed to be the Pope or whatever he is, to the bishops, to the whatever, pastors, preachers, prophets, evangelists, or nothing. I'm here to tell you, God doesn't show favoritism to you. Amen. And he called us to speak truth. And truth is love. Amen. But on that day, you're going to know this, spirits, that, you know, us that are out here, we're not here for what you can give us. We're here to give you what God has given us. Amen. So as we sit here, we go, beloved brothers and sisters. I'm going to sit here and pray that we did. I just wanted to come on here for a minute and read some, because that's been for this week. I haven't been on for a couple of days, but that's okay. Y'all know, and I post these also on YouTube, and I pray you guys share it and subscribe to it so it can get out there more. I'm not here to exalt myself. I'm not in no suit and a tie and a big old mech of the church, because we are the church. Amen. We are the stones. We are the stones that are being built, the spiritual house of God, as he tells us. And we're all scattered abroad, as the word of truth tells you. So stay focused, stay grounded in the truth, in the Lord, spirits. Amen. Not in man, in the Lord. Amen. And God is there. Look, the enemy has come against me ever since God ordained me. But nothing. He frustrates the devices of the enemy, but his hand is upon our lives, spirits. Amen. And he keeps us humble. Not exalted. He'll exalt us in old time, in due time. And the only exalting that I want is when I'm being raised up at the coming Amen. After tribulation. When he says, soon after the tribulations, the Christ will appear coming from heaven. Amen. Praise God. For us that are here. But he has worked out a lot of things, and though the enemy comes against us, God will exalt you. God will put you, raise a standard for him, okay? And he's done that in my life. So now I'm in a place that he needs me to be for his purpose, for his glory, to bring what he needs us to bring. And that's his way of correction, ways of encouragement, ways of rebuke, ways to exhort, ways to show people a better way, a life of peace, contentment, and true love and joy. Amen. And letting him deal with everything while you just live in his glory. Amen. That's the Almighty that I serve. So let us pray, beloved brothers and sisters. And then I got to go on about this day, but though the enemy may come against you, guess what? Have faith, true faith, in that Almighty, that Almighty God that we say out of our clay lips that we serve. And amen. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this day that you've given us, Lord. I love you more than life itself, and I thank you so much for everything that you are doing for me, Father God. You continue moving the mountains and continue making our path straight. Bless my brothers and that I got an opportunity to sit here in fellowship with today, Father God. Strengthen them spiritually in the heavenly places, Father God, and open up the windows of heaven and provide for us the things that we need to be able to distribute to those that are out there, Father God, whether it's in word or in deed, for you give us all things, Holy Father. By faith and believing you, Lord, I ask you that you bless this day and go with me wherever I'm going to accomplish everything that I need to accomplish for you. For it's your spirit and it's your might, Holy Father, that we sit here and we dwell in. I ask that you bless this reservation that I'm on continuously, Father God. Continue blessing this reservation that is right here, Father God. Strengthen them spiritually in the things that they lack, Father God. Having been separated from you, being blinded by the blessing that you have given unto them, Father God, and still leaving a disobedient and selective in how you. There's nothing impossible for you, and they're losing their lives, Lord, and from every nation, every tribe, and every tongue, Father God. But we're asking you that your mercy be upon their lives, Father God, that your mercy walk with us, that you forgive us, that you wash us, that you search our hearts, Lord, and lead us and guide us into all truth that we need. I love you, my mighty God. Above you, there is no one. Bless every member of your body, Father God. Every member of your body that is out there struggling, Father God, strengthen them. Give them the strength that you've given your servant, that you've blessed me with, Father God, to be able to sustain the wills of the enemy, Father God, no matter what it is. But then I thank you so much. In my Master Christ, Yeshua, Messiah, Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. He is the strength of our heart. Is he the strength of your heart? Bless you, brothers and sisters. Glory to you, Father. We bless your holy name this day, this holy sanctified Sabbath day. Abba, Ushua. You set my heart on ablaze with your holy fire. And now I stand amazed by your love and favor. You set my heart on favor. I don't know where I would be. I don't know what I would do if your love hadn't saved me. You are the strength of my life, and I'm eternally grateful. Great are you, Lord, over all. And I will declare, Lord, you are faithful. Great are you, Lord, over all. Great are you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Even though we aren't worthy of it, Father God, you are great and merciful to us, Father God. You set my heart ablaze with your holy fire, and now I stand amazed by your love and your favor. You lead us with cords of kindness and love. I don't know where I would be, I don't know what I would do now if your love hadn't saved me, Father God. You are the strength of my life, and I'm eternally grateful. Great are you, Lord, over all. We will declare, Lord, you are faithful. Over all, great are you, Lord. Abba, Kushua. We bless your holy name, Father God. Praise you, Lord. Glory to you, Abba, Father. Jehovah, Jehovah. We love you, Yahweh, knowing that you're there, Lord. Bless us with your Holy Spirit this day. Bless us with your peace and your contentment. Bless those that keep your covenant, Father God. Bless those that are obeying your commandments, Holy Father. Fill them more with your Spirit, Father God. For there's not nothing impossible for you, great I am. You are the great creator, and you are the potter, and we're the clay, Lord. Lead us and guide us into all truth and everything that we need that comes from you, Father God. We love you, Father. We need you. We're asking you to guide you, guide us each and every day. We bless your holy name this day, Lord, that you have made. And we will be glad and rejoice in it, Father God, on your holy sanctified day, Sabbath day, Father God, according to your word. We love you, Father. I love you. And I thank you. I love you, brothers and sisters. Y'all have a blessed and wonderful day. I know this was short, but we got the harvest is plenty. The laborers are few. It's time for the God is calling out to you. You called, you chosen, you elect. Amen. You stones, precious in the sight of God. We're going to be rejected by man, but we got God on our life. And you got the hand of the Lord on your side. Be strengthened this day. No fear with God. I love y'all. Have a blessed and wonderful day.